Christ, be it this Advent our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this church glad with our carols of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of his whole world and all his people, for peace upon the earth he came to save, for love and unity within the one church he did build, and for brotherhood and goodwill amongst all men, especially in this city of Boston. And because this, of all things, would rejoice his heart, let us at this time remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the sick in body and in mind, and them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in this Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself hath taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our coming day's bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into trial, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The Almighty God bless us with his grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life. And unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of angels bring us all. Amen. Amen.
tells sinful Adam that he has lost the life of paradise and that his seed will bruise the serpent's head. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden, and in the cool of the day, and Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam, and he said unto him, Where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself. He said, Who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree? Therefore thee thou shall not eat. And man said, Woman who thou gavest to me, she gaveth me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto woman, What thou hast done? And woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. That upon thy belly thou shalt go, and dust thou shalt eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and woman, between thy seed and her seed. I shall bruise thy head, I shall bruise his heel. Thanks be to God.
God promises to faithful Abraham
that in his seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time, and said, By myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore. And thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies, and in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. Thanks be to God.
The prophet foretells the coming of the Savior. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice, from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. prophet Micah foretells the glory of little Bethlehem. But thou, Bethlehem Ephratah, though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall he come forth unto me, that is to be ruler in Israel, whose goings forth have been from of old, from everlasting. Therefore will he give them up, until the time that she which travaileth hath brought forth. Then the remnant of his brethren shall return unto the children of Israel, and he shall stand and feed in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall abide, for now shall he be great unto the ends of the earth. Thanks be to God.
The angel Gabriel salutes the Virgin Mary. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
St. Luke tells of the birth of Jesus. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was, that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. the shepherds go to the manger. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us go now even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
wise men are led by the star to Jesus. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures and presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh, and being warned by God in the dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. Thanks be to God.
What an amazing treat that God has blessed us with this evening, the occasion to have these nine lessons and carols portray for us the panorama of redemptive history right up to its climax in the coming of our Lord Jesus at his incarnation. It is my privilege to extend to each of you a warm welcome this evening to Park Street Church. I suppose in keeping with the historical note that introduces the program, it would be appropriate for me to give a special thanks to those of you who left the pubs early tonight in order to add your sober voices to the choir, which is the entire congregation. It is a real gift to have you with us. There really are two aspects to the service that are a treat, and I want to highlight them. The first of them is that actually, despite the use of Elizabethan English and the lovely lyrics of such excellent carols, this is not just poetry. It is the fact that those who have sung for us from the choir, those who have spoken from this pulpit, every word that has been prayed is meant. It's believed. We're staking our lives on these truths, and we invite you to reaffirm your faith as we are ministered to through this remarkable service. The second feature that I want to stress is the fact that we have many special guests tonight. Many of you have come from well outside Greater Boston, at least from other churches, and I think it's an encouragement. If you wouldn't mind, just raise your hand if Park Street Church is not your spiritual home. You don't normally worship here. You're one of our special guests. Look at that. Amazing. What an amazing example of a slice of heaven to be able to come together around the shared conviction, the unity of our faith in Christ. And by the way, those of you who live nearby, this is a normal service for us. No, I didn't mean to say that. I couldn't help myself. I do have a treat for you. Right after the service, we have light refreshments available for all of you, and the floor immediately below the sanctuary in our welcome center. We hope that many of you will join us there.
Thank you.
St. John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, and that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
nation gathered into one, things earthly and heavenly, grant you the fullness of inward peace and goodwill, and make you partakers of the divine nature. In the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.